tell you, the perseverance of today is only a slight piece of the perseverance of getting this project done. And I know many people here today had that perseverance through many years to make this project happen. And I would say that this rain is only a slight issue over the long-term issues and tribulations that came up with this project, and today is definitely to be celebrated. And first, let me give a round of applause to the drummers and dancers from Grant Elementary School. Thanks for being here, guys. I hope we can continue to listen to your great production. These students perform on many different events, and we're very honored to have them here for the opening ceremony. Thank you so much for performing for us, and I hope it's not the end today. This is a very exciting day. Like I said, we gather today to celebrate the completion and opening of the first phase of the Martin Luther King Jr. Way in the heart of our growing and thriving university district. It's so great to have the senior leadership from our universities here today. Naming this entrance to the higher education after Dr. King is very appropriate. Dr. King believed in access to education and ensuring a better life for all people. Our university district provides a path to a successful future for our students who study here, and really for our entire community. This location is at the heart of our research and innovation and entrepreneurship. We're educating physicians soon to be, and nurses, and urban planners, architects, public administrators, and business leaders, all right here in the university district. And of course, we have many people and organizations that we need to acknowledge today who really started this work, persevered through this work, through the many years that this project has come to fruition. And I'll apologize up front. It's pretty exciting to see so many of those leaders here today. But I did want to thank quite a few, and those that are elected and those that are here representing the elected officials. First, I'd like to say thank you to the representatives from Senator Patty Murray's office and Senator Maria Cantwell, and in their part, and also the representatives from U.S. Congresswoman Kathy McMorris Rogers' office, the state senator, Lisa Brown. We do have with us today Representative Tim Ormsby and Andy Billig. And I also want to give a special thanks out to those from the Martin Luther King Jr. Family Outreach Center. We'll be hearing from Freda today, the local chapter of the NAACP, Ministers Fellowship, and many, many others who supported this process to name this street after Dr. King. Joining me up here today is Dorothy Webster, and, you know, really in the city persevered this project. And, you know, in many ways, we know this, that the city has many different departments and many different issues, and to have a leader in the city that shepherded this project through the city is so key, and it's great to have here today. The construction team, Spokane Rock Products and their subcontractors and employees with the city construction design teams. And we also have several other elected officials. It's great here today to have our council members, John Snyder, Nancy McGlock, Glenn over here. Who else am I? We have out here today. Oh, there we are, Steve Salvatore, Sheriff Ozzy, Mike Fagan, our county commissioners. Yep, this is their city too. Todd Milkey, Al French. Is Mark here? And then, of course, Beck Taylor from Whitworth. Thank you for being here. Also, Dr. Pritchard here, and many, many others. And so thank you for being here today. And truly, all of our education leaders and school partners, this is such a key part of our city. The University District and all its education, business, and community partners, including the Greater Spokane Incorporated, Downtown Partnership, Avista, and many more, and our entire community have made this happen. This new connection is a wonderful addition to our city infrastructure, and quite frankly, it features many of the elements, including bike lanes, street trees, wide sidewalks, and an elevated median. It reduces vehicle traffic to really on Spokane Falls Boulevard that really helps us create that university district. And quite frankly, this is phase one of our plans of a corridor. Phase two is planned for 2013. We'll run from Sherman Street out along the Spokane River, under the Hamilton Street Bridge, to Perry Street and to Trent Avenue. And we also have the third phase, which isn't funded, which will bring the pedestrian bike bridge over the railroad tracks we have right here to our south. So that is great. I will continue today, and I want to introduce a few folks that really were a key part of making this happen today. And starting that off is our own, in his third district, is Representative Tim Ormsby. Tim, it's great to have you here today and to represent the third district and Spokane on the House Capitol Budget Committee. I invite you to the podium.
Thank you, Mayor Condon. I'll try and be mercifully brief given the weather, and I know that there's a lot of important things that we have to do, and I just want to commend Mayor Condon for, you know, talking about overcoming adversity, because in any of these businesses, if you can't do that, then you're not going to have a successful project. And I think the rain today is just one more of those things that we have to overcome in order to get to completion. The congratulations go out to everyone because this is a huge community effort, particularly to our education community, healthcare, civic organizations all represented up here today, and the business and labor community as well. Hats off to you. It's fitting, I think, that we have named after Dr. King, and one of my the seminal quotes from him that I try and remember each and every day is that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. And I think when you have important work to do, you have to be in it for the long haul. You have to be vigilant and diligent. And that goes for a community vision like this, that it takes a little while. And just as a reminder, special credit I want to give to former Senator Chris Marr, who secured initial funding on this, and that was 5 years ago from the state. And it was one of the important dominoes that fell in order to get more of the local infrastructure here, whether it was the nursing school or now the medical school and all the other state-funded projects. And I'm just proud to be a part of a state government that recognizes the importance of this community vision and stepped up to participate in a very meaningful way. Thanks for having us, and congratulations to you all.
Following Tim will be Representative Andy Billig, and he also serves as the Vice Chair of the House Transportation Committee, and it's great to have him in his third district here today.
Thank you, Mayor Condon, and I'll defer to the weather with brevity, but I do want to say that I'm just so proud to stand here today with all of you as we honor a great American, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., and help our community take a big step forward with the opening of this boulevard. And this project and the entire university district is a tribute and honors Dr. King's passion for community and for education. This street contains so many complete street elements that provide for healthy and safe transportation. And the new pedestrian bridge, which there's some planning that started on that, the extensions and the elements that you see already in place are such a big step forward for us to be safe as we get to and from work and all of the other things in our life. The other thing that I just want to mention is that this project also paves the way, literally, for the Central City Line, which is our high-capacity transit that will be coming to our downtown, hopefully, in the next few years, or at least the planning will keep going in the next few years. So I look forward to the prosperity and growth that Martin Luther King Jr. Way will bring to Spokane, and I congratulate everyone who helped to make this day a reality. Thank you.
I'm going to introduce a couple more, and that is from our federal delegation, from Senator Pandy Murray's office, John Colton, and from Senator Cantwell's office, Tanya Royden. If you could come and share some words.
Coming up here. As you know, this project was funded in a different time through the earmark process. You know, this is one of those earmarks that really made sense, a great project for the community. The senator apologized she couldn't be here today, but she did send her warmest regards and a letter. Dear friends, I regret that I'm unable to be with you today to celebrate the completion of the Martin Luther King Jr. Way in Spokane, which marks an incredible milestone in building needed infrastructure for the University District. Martin Luther King Jr. Way will not only beautify the area by creating an inviting setting for the U District, it would also reduce automobile traffic around the Riverpoint campus while enhancing pedestrian safety. I have continued to support the Martin Luther King Jr. Way project through its initialization as well as development, and remain committed to investing in Spokane's infrastructure. As you know, I was able to make this project possible through almost $7 million of targeted funding, along with a tireless efforts of countless community members. This transportation improvement will not only provide economic stimulation by creating jobs, but it will also get us one step closer to the end goal of establishing a biomedical cluster in downtown Spokane. And we all cheered. Where's Rich Hadley to lead the cheer on this? Lastly, yet of greatest importance, this new roadway will serve as a reminder to the legacy of a great civil rights leader. By paying homage to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., we are symbolizing our community's commitment to civil rights and education, as is the legacy of Dr. King. It is fitting for this name to be given to a road that increases access to the University District, as Dr. King was so passionate about access to education for all. So congratulations to the City of Spokane and all of the community leaders involved in making Martin Luther King Jr. Way the newest addition to the University District. God bless Senator Patty Murray.
Good morning, everybody. It's an honor to be here with you today. Unfortunately, Senator Cantwell isn't able to join us, but I have a short message from her I'd like to share. Dear friends, I sincerely regret that I'm unable to join you for today's celebration of the opening of Martin Luther King Way. Dr. Martin Luther King envisioned a peaceful, just world and opportunities for education for all. Martin Luther King Jr. Way represents these ideals in many ways. Dr. Martin Luther King Way is a project funded by federal, state, and local sources to unite our higher education and downtown community by providing a safe and inviting corridor of access, including cycling, walking, driving, and public transit. It is in this spirit of collaboration that we will continue to bolster economic revitalization, justice, and education opportunities throughout the Spokane region. Thank you to everyone who has made this day possible, and for honoring Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. in such a beloved way for future generations to benefit from. Sincerely, Marie Cantwell, United States Senator.
Dorothy asked me to do something about the rain. I can't do that, but I can make sure the MC duties go quicker. So I'm gonna introduce the next three speakers. Michaela Williams from Senator Lisa Brown's office, who obviously has been such a huge advocate for Spokane, and it was great to work with her this year on many issues facing the city. After her will be Frida Gandhi, and Frida I met on my first day on the job. Where are you, Frida? Somewhere out here. You here? Let's make sure. From the Martin Luther King's Family Outreach Center, she'll speak, then Dr. Brian Pitcher, from the Chancellor of Washington State University. So it's great to have those next three up here.
Good morning. Senator Brown was very sorry she wasn't able to be here today, but she did send this letter. Dear friends, I'm very moved by the completion of the landmark that we're celebrating today, a landmark with particular significance in our community. I was honored to march alongside many of you during the 2012 Martin Luther King Jr. Day Parade. And though I regret that I cannot join you in person today, I assure you that I'm celebrating in solidarity from afar. Many of you know that I have a painting in my office by local artist Ben Joyce entitled 16,582 Days to a Symphony of Brotherhood. This painting commemorates the number of days from Dr. King's remarkable speech to the swearing-in of our first African-American president. We've come a long way as a nation, but the averted tragedy last year served as a painful reminder of how far we have yet to come. But as Dr. King said, we cannot walk alone, and as we walk, we must make the pledge that we shall always march ahead. We cannot turn back. So today, into the very foundation of our community, we are inscribing a commitment to march ahead together, to continually work toward the fulfillment of Dr. King's dream. And I look forward to walking alongside you in our unyielding efforts to bring that dream home. Thank you.
I thank you all for being with us today. This is an exciting, thrilling time for the University District, for the River Point campus. It's my pleasure to speak on behalf of all of the education partners. We're all here in one way or another, and we're united in helping to provide opportunity, educational opportunity, and access for this next generation. You know, it's important that we recognize the many, many years of partnership and collaboration that has made this possible. We thank the federal and the state delegations, the local government. We have been pleased to work with several city administrations for just truly excellent city staff and helped with the design and the development of the street and to bring the safety and other improvements to the campus. This project is indeed a milestone in the progress of the River Point campus in the University District to create a more walkable, bikeable campus, more safely and seamlessly connected to downtown and to one another. It has been a wonderful collaboration of the community collectively. I recall at the naming of the street some months ago, almost 2 years ago, the enthusiasm and the passion that was evident that day. Dr. King truly represents the catalytic force in our society, and this street and this gateway to the community represents our future. It represents the opportunities that we have when we it is certainly very appropriate that a university boulevard be named in honor of Dr. King. He valued education. You will recall at age 19, he wrote that essay when he was at Morehouse College, where he challenged people to think more critically, but not stop at that, but to focus on worthy objectives. Certainly, this is a worthy objective, to create a healthier community, a connected community for all, a future for all. It's our pleasure to participate, and we thank you all for your efforts. We are excited to see the street open today and have an opportunity to drive down here and anticipate the future projects and development of this campus. It's a very great pleasure to be with you.
I see a few more that have joined us. Ben Stuckert, the president of the council, it's great to have you here. Sheila Collins from the governor's office, and also a key part in making this happen. The next three, I'd like to first introduce Marlon Nunberg, the vice president of the Downtown Spokane Partnership, who really, this is also the university district, and Downtown Partnership has such a key role in making that happen. Also, Keith Medcalf, the Eastern Washington Director of the Washington State Transportation Department. Keith has been such a strong advocate, and I've worked with him for many years now to make all kinds of projects happen for Eastern Washington. And also the Executive Director of the Transportation Improvement Board deserves our thanks, as the TIB provides significant funding for this project. Steve Gorsester, you know. So we'll have those next three come up here.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm excited to be here on behalf of the Downtown Spokane Partnership and the University District. It's an exciting time today. So much has happened in the University District over the last several years, turning it from so-called into reality, with its name now visible here on Division Street at the front door of the district. The vision has become reality thanks to the University District partners, the City, Greater Spokane Incorporated, Avista, the universities, and key business leaders. And I can't forget Brandon Betty, our University District Manager. These are the people that wake up every day and think about how to make it all happen here for the University District. Over $850 million have already been invested in the University District since the community had its master plan in 2004, and there's more to come. It's projects like this that create a sense of place and awareness, causing calls from future job-creating businesses to come into our office on a weekly basis. This Martin Luther King Jr. Way project unifies downtown's entertainment and office address, including over 25,000 employees, with the university district's more than 11,000 students. The synergy between the two creates the pulse for the future of our city. The gateway to the university district is significant in that it's the first in a series of future improvements to the Division Street corridor and gateways to our city, creating a welcoming environment for our visitors, students, and future businesses. The gateway and pedestrian amenity improvements, such as these, have been proven in other cities to increase sales, and therefore sales taxes, by at least 10% and up to 30%. Division, a street that should more appropriately be named Unity Street, and its ability to marry these two districts together, will create a vitality that will last a lifetime. Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Washington State Department of Transportation and the Federal Highway Administration, I'm delighted to be here today to join you in the much anticipated completion of this phase one of the Martin Luther King Jr. Way. We're pleased to have a small part of this through our local Highways and Local Programs Division, who administers the federal funds to support local communities. Through the Highways and Local Programs Division, the City of Spokane was provided $3.4 million for this phase. $2.9 million of it was federal funds. $500,000 came through the state legislature. Our headquarters and regional staff provided support to the city and the project team to guide and assist their staff in complying with the federal requirements such as environmental laws, right-of-way acquisitions, and contracting laws. Infrastructure improvements are key to our economic recovery. This one has a special benefit of the improved mobility in and around the city and the university district. We're pleased to be working with the city on other improvements within the university district as well. The city and DOT have worked very well together for improvements for regional transportation, and I want to congratulate you on a job well done.
Thank you. I'm Steve Gorsester, Director of the Washington State Transportation Improvement Board. We're a state grant agency for local governments. We get to collect about 10% of the state gas tax and invest it back in local communities. We're pleased to bring about 55% of the project cost back to the City of Spokane from your gas tax for this project. I want to mention we're represented here by one of my board members, Greg Parch, Commissioner from Whitman County. Thanks for being here, and Gloria Bennett, our project engineer for the region. This project, I have to say, I've been saying in Western Washington, this is our best project in Eastern Washington. And there are some specific reasons based on what we are asked to invest in by the legislature. Just some of the things we're asked to invest in: economic development, support for existing downtowns, safety of pedestrians and motorists, multimodal mobility, freight mobility. This project has it all. It crosses the spectrum. So we're very pleased to not only invest in this project, but we have already made a grant of $2.7 million for the next phase. So we're really happy to see this project moving forward to completion. It's going to produce a great deal of community benefits. We have more than 350 projects statewide, and as you can imagine, some of them have trouble getting themselves built. So we like to recognize the ones that do with these project completion plaques. This one presented to the City of Spokane Mayor David Condon in recognition of our successful partnership in completing Martin Luther King Jr. Way. May 2012, grant funding from us, the Washington State Transportation Improvement Board. Doesn't say us. But it does recognize the local legislators, because there's a lot of pressure on 3 cents of the state gas tax in Olympia. A lot of places you could spend it. Without their support, we wouldn't be spending it here on this project. So the plaque recognizes the support of the 3rd District State Legislator, Senator Lisa Brown, Representative Andy Billig, and Representative Tim Ormsby.
Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. I have a few more that have joined us. Representative John Ahern, also Rich Hadley, thanks for being here on behalf of GSI and your participation in the University District. We are all here. Yes, it's a street, and I am a mayor, so I like streets, and I like streets that are good to drive on. But we're truly here to honor a legend and a leader in our country. And I did want to talk a little bit about that, but I think probably the best, and like I said, today it may be raining, but this is a long time coming, and to recognize and give her a moment to talk a little bit about this process, and that's Dorothy Webster, who, like I said, worked tirelessly within the city to make this come to fruition, and truly, like I said, make it a part of who we honor today. So, Dorothy.
Thank you, and hello to everyone. First of all, I'd like to simply acknowledge the hard work and say thank you to those city employees with whom I had the privilege to process the internal processes in order to bring this to fruition today. They were tireless in sharing their expertise, and they were always on point, guiding us through every step. And so to you city employees, I do want to say thank you for your assistance here. On a personal note, this is really meaningful to me because in 1968, I had the opportunity to actually meet Dr. King. He came to the Tuskegee campus and spoke to us, and I had an opportunity not only to sit and listen, but also to shake his hand. And I want you to know I wore glove on this hand for a week because I didn't want to wash it off. And so it was just such a meaningful moment to me. But what he left us with that night, that Saturday night he spoke, is that, yes, he has articulated his dream through the years, but he told us to have our own dreams and to work hard in order to make those dreams a reality. And as I was driving here, I thought about today, as well as the day that the Spokane community erected the Michael Anderson statue. And I thought, what a perfect marriage. We're honoring the visionary, but we also honored a person who actually worked hard, who dared to dream and make his dream a reality. And so to each of you, in the words of Dr. King that night in 1968, dream, work hard, and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dorothy. I would like to call up a couple more leaders in our community, and that's Reverend Percy Happy Watkins, which I still, Reverend, have a message on my first day on the job from Happy, and I've kept it because I know I'll replay it every once in a while, because he said, and quite honestly throughout the years, he said he was here to serve the city, and truly I can't think of a better time to recognize the Reverend today, and also Mr. Bush for all they have done for Spokane, for advancing equality. You two individuals, this community, you've brought this community together. They have each spent a lifetime of breaking down barriers. I mean, look at today. I mean, like I said, there's so many of us here today from all walks of life, from all over the city, political and otherwise, and these two embody so much of what Martin Luther King talked about and did. It is my understanding, though, that after 3 decades of service, and I sat in the crowd like many of you did that day of the Martin Luther King Unity March, that they are turning over the reins of that. And Reverend Watkins and Mr. Bush will be retiring from that organizational work that they did for that annual march. And I couldn't, and I don't know, but I know they're working to find people to fill their shoes. But today is not about that. It is about a celebration. And at this place, at this time, around a common desire to promote equal rights for all. Reverend Watkins and Mr. Bush, with your welcoming spirit and open hearts, you have led this community to be better. I don't know how we can truly say thank you, but I can offer this gesture in token of our city appreciation. I would like to present on behalf of the citizens of Spokane to recognize your community service and dogged pursuit of what's right. On behalf of the citizens of Spokane, I'm honored to offer you both a key to the city of Spokane, and I'd ask you to come up to give a few remarks and I know a few words of encouragement to our community.
Mr. Bush, thank you.
And they are inscribed in honor of the dream 2012.
Walt Disney wrote a gospel song. When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desire will come true. If your heart is in your dream, no regret is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, as dreamers do. 25 years ago, my best friend had a dream to name a street Martin Luther King Jr. That was 25 years ago. Over those 25 years, there was disappointments and some setbacks, roadblocks, tears, heartaches. He even fell on his back. But I'm so glad he fell on his back, because when he could look up, he could get up. And so over the 25 years, people like the MLK, who donated some money, Frida Gandhi, NAACP, Ann Smith, the Minister's Fellowship, Brother Pierce, and then other individuals like the former mayor, Mary Vernon. And then inside the city hall, there was that tenacious Dorothy Webster. May I say this, this is a reality. Martin Luther King once said, I've been to the mountaintop. And I looked over and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I know that you'll reach the promised land. And today, I'm standing on the promised land. For my eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He has trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath have stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. I want to shout today, his truth is marching on. To my best friend, now I can close my eyes because I have seen the promised land and standing on the promised land. Thank you.
Thank you, Dorothy.
It's extremely difficult, as you can wonder, to try to speak behind Reverend Watkins. It is a difficult task. Dr. King said, the time to do right is always right. Spokane, you've done something right. You've done something right. And it just feels good. Dr. King had three principles that he used to guide him. First was his faith. Second was his family. Third was education. This street naming embodies all three of those principles. Yes, it took faith that no matter how long it took, that we'd be in this position one day. Yes, education. The more folks got together, talked about it, educated each other about the value and the importance of something such as this. And yes, it took family. And it's my hope this day that every time folks utilize this street or drive or journey by it, that we will all recognize that we are a family, that we have to ensure that there's a place sitting at the table for each and every one of us, that we value and embrace the many and varied differences that we all bring. That's what this means to me. We are the Spokane family. We value difference. We try to make a difference. And we strive to make a difference to doggone it. Making a difference don't make a difference anymore. That's what we are as a community. And that's why I hope, my hope is that we continue that journey together and that there's a place at the table for all the brothers and the sisters. Mayor Condon, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Dorothy, I appreciate you. And to all of those who have made this happen, thank you.
And we do have another one that made this happen that has come, former Mayor Mary Verner. It's, you know, in our, thanks for being here today. You know, and in our democracy, you know, many of us start projects and you always like to see them come to fruition, and it's great to have her here today because with Dorothy and her leadership to make this happen. And I would invite, after we do a few closing things, that both the mayor, Mayor Verner, and Dorothy, if you would join us in the first car here with our two other honorees right behind, to be the first cars to drive on this road to see this this project come to a close. It would be a great honor to have you do that. But before we do that, we were started with great musicians, and we will end with great musicians. I'll have to echo your words, Mr. Bush. I didn't know whether I wanted to get back up here after both the Reverend and you spoke, but we all need to do what we need to do. But I would like to introduce Martin Herford, a local recording artist and worship leader at All Nations Christian Center, who began singing at the age of 5. Since then, Martin placed in the Spokane's top 4 at the X Factor and has performed on many venues, including the Spokane Shock and Gonzaga Games. Martin Herford will be singing Precious Lord, Take My Hand. Accounts of Mr. King's life say that this was the last song he requested moments before he was shot. It also was sung at his funeral and at the dedication of the new King Memorial in Washington, D.C., and I would say if you ever have a chance, you should go there. It is amazing. Some say the song addresses some of the helplessness he felt as a minister constantly faced by the threats of attack. So it's great to welcome Martin to the microphone, and like I said, thereafter, if the dignitaries would join us at the cars to drive on this great, great street that has brought so many of us together on this rainy afternoon. Thanks for being here, and Martin, take it away.
I just want to say this is an honor to be a part of this great event. I want to thank Annie for giving me this opportunity. Thank you all. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, yes, through the night, lead
on to the light. Take my hand and precious Lord, and lead me home when my way grows dreary. Precious Lord, linger near when my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, Lord. Hear my call. Hold my hand, lest I fall. Oh, Lord, take my hand, take my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, and lead. Lead me home.
So if you could, grab a balloon, remove the string, and release it into the air while those honored guests, Mayor Werner and Dorothy, and our two recipients of the City of the Key, or the Key of the City, who truly have opened up so much in our community, would join us over in the Hasse Car Club for these great classic cars that were from Dr. King's era. Thank you. They add just the right touch for today. And then many of you can enjoy the pecan tartlets over here. I understand the pecan pie was Mr. King's favorite, one of his favorite foods. So thank you for coming today, and please be safe, and it's a great day, obviously, here in Spokane.